Hello and welcome to the season finale of On the Couch. I'm Brittany.
And I'm Eric. Thank you for joining us. To start off the show today, we're here with Jamie and Danielle to talk about Pros. What's going on, guys? How you doing?
Hi.
How are you?
So what is Pros exactly? I think it's something to do with the orientation, I think, like that.
Pros stands for the Peer Referral Orientation Staff. So there are student leaders that kind of help out in the summer, and they help welcome all the new students into Rowan.
Okay. So how do you get involved with Pros?
Sure. So all the positions, the staff positions, are for undergrads. So you apply online on ProfLink. We have our applications are actually open right now. Mm-hmm. And you schedule a group interview, and then you come in and you know, we see how you interact with different people. You might get invited back to a one-on-one interview. And if you get hired, we do a bunch of training in the spring to get ready for the summer. And then it's a really good time. They move in June. Mm-hmm. And then we have about 15 orientations where we bring in all new students, transfer students, all different types of programs. And we do the orientations for them, and they kind of help the new students get adjusted and mm-hmm. ask questions and help them make their schedules and things like that. So you just apply and then interview and join our staff.
Okay. So what do each of you do? Like, do each of you have a title with Pros?
Yep. So I, this past year, was a team leader for the peer referral and orientation staff. So for the orientation staff last year, there was 6 team leaders, and we oversaw a group of Pros members who were either parent Pros or student Pros. So that is the group you mostly worked with. So I worked with student Pros who are mainly focused with incoming students who would be majoring in the humanities and social science fields, so political science, economics, history, English, GIS, mm-hmm. that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm. And I'm the graduate coordinator for orientation, mm-hmm. so I'm a grad student and I work in the office about 20 hours a week, mm-hmm. And I do all the kind of the planning, scheduling all the rooms, and then I help out a lot with the staff selection process.
Oh, so I
review everyone's application, mm-hmm. And then I sit in on most of the interviews and kind of help figure out what we're going to do for the different trainings and maybe like some fun like staff outings or things like that. I help plan all of those things for the summer.
Okay. So how long, I guess each of you, how long have you been a part of Pros? Is this like a year by year thing, or can you roll into like while you're in college? How does that work?
So I started off with Pros my freshman year here at Rowan. Mm-hmm. So the December that I started school, I applied for Pros, and then I was notified that I got the position in February mm-hmm. the following year. So I've been with Pros for my entire undergraduate career.
Nice.
You're more than welcome to apply for multiple years, mm-hmm. or if you are only able to do 1 year with the orientation staff, that's also available. But if it's something you're interested in, it can be done throughout your whole undergraduate time here at Rowan.
That's mm-hmm. cool.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. It seems like it's a lot of fun. So, like, I guess being a part of Pros, what's like, do you guys have any memorable things that you want to share? Like, do you have any like good memories or anything?
So our staff, I like to think of it as probably the most fun staff on campus mm-hmm. to be a part mm-hmm. of. You can ask any single one of the Pros members at any given point to whip out like a really good like team building activity mm-hmm. or some kind of like icebreaker. All those like really anxious or like things that people always think are like really scary at the beginning of orientation. Just to get to know each other. They have like all kinds of cool games that they can play like on the spot, like blindfolded mm-hmm. dodgeball, and there's like this game called Ships and Sailors and all these cool stuff.
Yeah.
And it's just to like kind of help you make friends and to meet new people.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my favorite part of it, because like they are so welcoming and they can kind of like have a lot of fun with their job, and there's a lot of opportunities to kind of play throughout the day and to meet new people and to kind of interact with them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my favorite part.
So my favorite part is working directly with parents and students who are coming in for the orientation program itself.
Mm-hmm.
So I like meeting all of the new incoming students at Rowan and their parents, guardians, and make them just feel welcome at Rowan, make them feel like it's their home, that they're prepared here to start school. Also, I enjoy seeing them in the fall or spring semester mm-hmm. after they started and having a conversation with them about what's your favorite part this semester, how's it going. I love when they recognize me and we mm-hmm. recognize mm-hmm. each other and we get to kind of exchange information again and see how we're both enjoying our time here at Rowan.
It's interesting because I remember as a transfer here,
mm-hmm.
so my first contact was pros. So I remember seeing one of the pros people walking around, like, hey, remember me? Mm-hmm. And being a transfer, you know, mm-hmm. it's kind of rough, but it was good to notice someone that I met before school started. So you guys are very much needed.
Yeah. So you guys pretty much, whatever, you, like, depending on your major, that's kind of who you work. Don't you, like, usually work with the majors of the students? Because I remember, I think the person that was my pros leader at my transfer orientation this past summer, mm-hmm. He was an RTF major like May, mm-hmm. and then it was like I think like also a journalism major and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. So we hire, we actually really pride ourselves in hiring a very diverse staff. So you'll see like there's no cookie cutter image of what a pros member is. They have all different personalities, all different majors. Because coming in as a freshman or as a transfer student, mm-hmm. you want to be able to relate to somebody. So mm-hmm. if you meet 35 of the same person in a yellow polo, it's really not going to help you out much. But if you can find someone that's maybe the same major as you or like you like some of the same things, it's really cool to kind of be able to have that connection. Mm-hmm. So we do hire like all different kinds of majors just so somebody, you can find somebody you relate to. Mm-hmm. Or they might be signing up for classes and say, hey, I really like taking this class the same time I took this class because they went together really well. Mm-hmm. So it's cool that like you can kind of find someone that really will help you out and have had related experiences. So we really, really love that about our staff, and we definitely look for that to kind of have a well-rounded staff of all different kinds of people.
That's cool. So now as a student organization, like many student organizations I've noticed have on campus, you guys have any social media that if you want to get in contact with yep. students, they can follow you or anything like that?
We definitely have social media. So orientation is run through the Orientation and Student Leadership office here at Rowan. Mm-hmm. If you're interested, we are located on the second floor of Savitz. But we do have a Facebook page and we do have a Twitter. And our Facebook page is just Rowan OSLP. And then our Twitter is at Rowan OSLP.
All right, cool.
That's awesome.
Look forward to hearing back from you maybe through social media. I'll give you guys a shout out or something. Or
great, thanks so much.
Follow or well, what have you.
Yep.
Also, if anybody's interested in joining PROS, the last day for applications is December 23rd.
All right. Sweet.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for coming and chatting with us. When we get back, we will hear from PRSSA and Praction. Don't go away.
If you drive buzzed, it could cost you around $10,000. You'll face major legal fees, major fines, and steep insurance penalties. You could lose everything. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Welcome back to On the Couch. So we just heard from Jamie and Danielle. Now we're here with Katarina DeFelice and Emily Proventer, okay, from Praction and PRSSA. Hi, guys.
Hi, girls. How you doing?
Hi, thanks for having
us. Hi. So PRSSA, one of the best clubs, okay? I'm a little favoriting right now. So tell us more about PRSSA. What does it stand for?
Sure. So PRSSA is the Public Relations Student Society of America. Mm-hmm. It's a preeminent pre-professional society on campus. We help students with their resumes. We have a lot of networking opportunities both in the state and regionally, and we actually go to national conferences as well. So we're actually going to send two people to Seattle in February.
Nice.
Awesome. Do you know where they're going to go in Seattle?
I don't. It's just a hotel in Seattle that they're going to actually vote on the new bylaws for our entire society for next year.
Okay, cool. Wow, that's awesome.
Sure.
Yeah, and then Praction is like a sister club of PRSSA. It stems from it. It's the more operational, so it's like our firm. And mm-hmm. so you have actual clients who work in groups doing PR work for we have a couple different clients. And then Praction, it grew so much so it kind of turned into a class, a practicum class. Mm-hmm. So that it just gives people more opportunities to work like with real world clients and get resume, portfolio experience before they graduate.
Okay. Cool. So what are your majors?
Sure.
Katarina?
So I'm a PR and advertising double major mm-hmm. with a minor. It just turned to a minor in new media.
Nice.
Yeah, and I am a PR and advertising double major as well.
Okay. Cool.
Yes.
So I think you mentioned two words. I can't really remember it with the classes or whatever. It began with a P.
Practicum.
Yeah,
practicum.
Can you explain a little bit of like what that is, if it like goes in with your program?
Yeah, so practicum is you can take it either junior or senior year. They have an advertising one as well as a PR one, and it's a class where you get graded to do what you would do in Praction. So it's not like a regular class. You have group members, you have a client, mm-hmm. and we'll meet like once a week and kind of be updating like, what are you doing for your client? How can we help? And so me and our firm director, who's not here right now, Angela Zarino, we work with the advisor, Professor Schoenstein, and with the students and kind of just, it's really not like completely structured. It's like they work with the clients completely. They're the contact and everything like that. We kind of just give them a little bit of like guidance and mm-hmm. stuff like that. So yeah, it's really cool, cause especially if you do Praction, which a lot of students will start out in Praction mm-hmm. if they're in PRSSA, and then be like, I'm doing all the work, might as well get credit for it. So mm-hmm. it's just like a 3-credit elective.
It's kind of like almost like an internship.
Yeah,
but you get credit
yeah.
for it, which
yeah.
is really cool. Yeah. You get real life experience.
Yeah,
right?
We really try to push that. Like PRSSA is so like, you learn so much about mm-hmm. the major and about the field and everything like that. And then Praction kind of gives people the chance to like actually apply and stuff like that. So mm-hmm. it's really awesome. Mm-hmm. Plus if you can't get an internship or you're too young to have an internship, you can actually still have experience just from being in school. Mm-hmm. So
sweet.
So cool. Katarina, you just did a Disney, right? A Disney
yes,
internship.
I participated in the Disney College program mm-hmm. my sophomore spring. So that'd be February 2015 to August 2015. Mm-hmm. And I do really credit PRSSA's all the things that I learned from PRSSA to getting that internship. Mm-hmm. I was an entertainment cast member, and I really felt that being in front of PRSSA and being able to speak to all the members in an executive board position, as well as learning my leadership skills, my organizational skills, really helped me get that experience. And I was fortunate enough while I was down at Disney to still be elected vice president of the next semester for PRSSA.
Nice.
So, mm-hmm. and I made a connection down there as well. I have a marketing coordinator that handle Star Wars weekends, all the very Merry Christmas parties.
Sweet.
And he'll Skype into Rowan usually in the fall semester mm-hmm. to talk to us about his event planning do's and don'ts.
He's so nice. Yeah. He's like so helpful just from Skype.
Yeah.
Now, the job that you had with the Disney College program, is that like part of your, does that kind of fit into your major?
I'd like to fit it into my major a little bit more. I say that I learned nonverbal and verbal communication cues while I was there.
Right.
Played characters when I was down there, so I got to interact with children and adults all day long, but I really did learn how to communicate what I needed without using my voice, because I was in a costume all day and I couldn't talk.
I guess I'm going to kind of get off topic, but I got to ask, what characters were you? I got to find this out.
So it has to stay at Rowan because I'm not really supposed to tell anyone, but I played 15 different characters.
Woo!
My favorites were Mickey and Minnie, obviously.
Sweet.
But
That's pretty cool.
It was really cool. I got to open the Magic Kingdom a lot of the days with the White Rabbit from Alice in Wonderland.
Sweet. And
so that was really great, too.
So you actually had to wear like the actual costumes. Like, you weren't just like...
Oh, no. I was in full costume all day. It was great. It was a great experience.
That's awesome. So Praction, is there any clients that you can talk about that for this upcoming semester?
Yeah, so one of our clients is the Yogo on Rowan Boulevard. Mm-hmm. That's one that's been a recurring client for a couple years now. Caddy actually started out on that account a couple years ago. So we do some social media and some event planning for them. And we'll also do Organ Donor Day.
It's one of my favorite
days. Yeah, it's an event that happens every year through PRSSA. Mm-hmm. So we actually turned that into a client where a team specifically, I actually worked on it last year. Mm-hmm. The whole semester is just like learning event planning, reaching out to the media, writing press releases and stuff like that, and then actually putting together a committee and putting together the entire event. So that's a really cool one. So mm-hmm. that'll be in April. So definitely look out for that one.
Okay. So you were saying something about in April, so this sounds like it's something that's coming upcoming now. Is there anything else that's coming up in the future that maybe you guys want to talk about, like maybe something coming up in the next semester, next year, any changes to the club, anything exciting maybe you want students to know about?
Sure. Would you like to start? Or?
Yeah, well, just next semester, so we do like start with clients again at the beginning of the semester. So if anyone is interested in PR, advertising, like journalism or anything like that, it's never too late to get involved. So definitely just encouraging people to get involved in PRSA and also Praction. And if they did want to get like experience, I know you said even you're a journalism like minor, even if you wanted to just get experience doing like press releases or media kits or anything like that, definitely look out for Practicum to join next semester. It's really low-key, like not even a lot of work, to just something to help out your resume.
So. That's pretty cool though. So like you were saying that you guys work with like the business, like some businesses, right? So you're actually making like PR packages for like actual businesses.
Yeah.
And it's just you're doing it as a club.
Yeah.
That's actually really cool.
It's all pro bono work. A lot of the other PRSSA chapters that have firms pay, like have people pay them, but we do all pro bono work for Glassboro clients. And actually, I made a flyer and it's up at Yogo right now. So if people don't know, like don't think that what they'll give to the businesses is going to be used, it really is used.
That's pretty cool.
Have to say, like, because of PRSSA, I was able to get a communications job in D.C., so
that's awesome.
Definitely it's a great club to be involved with, and it's really good because they start you off early and working with professional clients. So.
Definitely, yeah, because I like how you get, it's really cool how you guys seem to, like, get, because I feel like sometimes you could, this is what I always say, like, you can only learn so much in the class, but unless you really get out to into a club and to actually do what you want to do, you're not going to really learn as much. But now that you guys actually have the opportunity to get out actually and do like public relations stuff and for like real businesses too, it sounds like it's something that's really helpful.
Sure. And something I'd love to add with upcoming events, we mentioned Organ Donor Day. We are actually the only PRSSA chapter in the nation to award a national award at our conference, and that is our NODAC, or National Organ Donor Awareness Competition. So that is our Organ Donor Day, and we award $400, $300, $200, and $100 prizes to the top four schools.
Sweet.
So that nice. We've done That's that. Great. We've done that for about 20 years, and we in April we're starting another one. So unfortunately, one of our past vice presidents passed away from cystic fibrosis. In her senior year in 2012. So in her memory, we have a Dance Away Cystic Fibrosis, which just happened on December 3rd. That will now be a national competition as well through PRSSA. Nice. And we have...
That's awesome.
So we're really excited.
It's exciting. How can people get in touch on social media? What are your handles?
Rowan Praction is just Rowan Praction on Twitter and Instagram and the Facebook page. So just searching that, like Action PR, putting PR into action, so that's what that name is.
And Rowan PRSSA, our technical name is AJF PRSSA, but all of our handles are just at Rowan PRSSA, as well as our website, just Rowan PRSSA, and that has a Praction site as well.
Okay. Awesome. I mean, that sounds really cool. I like the whole, like I said, I think it's like really good to get students like experience with the whole public relations thing, and you're actually doing it for real businesses. And
we are.
It seems like you guys really have like a hands-on kind of club almost. Like you're really going out and doing stuff. That's pretty cool though. It all sounds really great.
Any advice you can give any students?
Sure. Well, at least if you're a PR and advertising student, every speaker that we've had come, mostly a Rowan alum. One of them is the director of communications for all of North America Toys R Us, so you can go far. But they always say, you know, if you're not joining PRSSA, you're not doing something right, or Praction. You need to have some kind of professional organization on your resume, and we make it really easy. Our meetings are on Wednesdays at 5 in the Student Center. It's a central location, and we usually have food sometimes too. We alternate with
Every Praction. Other week, so when it's not PRSSA, it's Praction, so it's easy to do both also.
And all of the e-board is more than willing to meet with you outside of classes or in classes. We just want to make sure that you get the experience that you are paying for at Rowan, and to be a good and very accomplished PR and advertising professional.
Sweet. That all sounds really good, guys. Thanks. You so much for coming
Thanks
on.
Thanks so much Thank for having you. Us.
Stay right here. We also have the man on the street coming up in just a bit. Don't worry. You're right here. I'm keeping it here and on the couch.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed, it could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Through the snow in a deck the halls with boughs. Hark, the herald angel sings. Man on the street. This week's word on the street is I don't know how to sing holiday tunes. Jingle bells, jingle all the
way.
Maybe it's cold outside. Are you listening?
In the lane.
Snow is glistening.
Beautiful sight.
Happy tonight? Winter Wonderland. Later on, we'll perspire as we dream by the fire. Songs that we make, walking in a winter wonderland.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw him, well, you would say it glows.
Ornaments are really cool. I'm out here singing like a fool. Holiday tree. I love you lots! Holiday tree!
I don't know the rest of the words.
Me neither.
I really don't know them.
Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Then how the reindeer completely had to turn around and love him all of a sudden. Almost nobody wants to sing with me. Now, I understand singing might not be everybody's forte, but it's fun getting the holiday spirit. Any holiday you celebrate, go for it. Have a good time. Celebrate with family, friends. Get out there. Make memories. Sing if you want to, no matter what holiday songs you celebrate. Go ahead and sing them. It'll be fun, right? He agrees.
That was awesome. I give him a lot of props just because it looked like he was like so cold out there.
He didn't even have a coat on.
I was getting into it a little bit.
He made me cold. But you definitely deserve a Grammy for your voice. It's fabulous. So you ready for the hot topics?
Sure. Why not? Let's get going. I don't know. You first. Go ahead.
Okay.
What do you got? Anything good?
So I love AI. AI is like one of the best ever. Play basketball.
AI being
Allen Iverson.
Allen Iverson, right? All right.
The one and only AI.
Yeah, just making sure on the same page.
So they're having a Hall of Fame game December 18th, Sixers game, home game. So I'm excited to watch.
Yeah, I actually did hear about this. I'm really happy that they are honoring AI because AI is probably, in my book, he's probably the best Sixer of, if not one of the best 76ers of all time. I really can't remember when we've had in Philadelphia, I can't remember when the Sixers have really had a player like Allen Iverson, who is probably one. I think he was NBA MVP, I think in 2001, I want to say, something like that. He was an insane player, and I mean, I miss those days. Mm-hmm. Being a Sixers fan, I miss those days because he was always really entertaining to watch, and the team was, really good, and stuff like that. So, but I mean, they're getting there. They'll be there at some point.
The answer has been answered. So, what do you have next?
All right. So, my hot topic is that the they're called the AirPods, I think they're called. AirPods. Yes, the Apple AirPods. I think it's it's like these wireless earphones that were supposed to come out like 2 months ago. They've been delayed. Now they're being sold online officially. Now they're available for sale. I think they started at like $159. So it's kind of a little pricey.
Yeah.
But there's only one downside out of it. It's apparently taking about like 4 weeks to, it's like an estimate about 4 weeks to ship. So sadly, there are not going to be probably available for the holidays this year.
That's sad.
But I mean, you can always get them as a Christmas gift and then give them to a post-Christmas and be like, okay, this is what I intended to get you.
Like,
it is past Christmas, but
like a cutout. This is what it is. Wrap that up.
Right.
That's cool. Apple AirPods.
AirPods, I think it's called. It can't be AirPods. Interesting. It's got to be AirPods, I'm pretty sure.
Well, so what are you doing for the holidays?
Relaxing. Getting over this semester.
Same here.
I guess you're probably doing the same thing.
Same here.
Yeah, it's going to be nice to just go home and relax a little bit. So.
Well, that's all we have for this episode of On the Couch. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Make sure to get in touch with us on Twitter, social media, how would have you. I actually did change my Twitter name, so it's going to be @Eric_GLS because I just became an official member of Rowan Radio. So I'm
nice.
Re-imaging my Twitter towards that. So it's @Eric_GLS.
And I'm @BrittaniAshanti. Plain and simple.
I'll make sure.
One T and an I.
Sorry, I may cut you off. I'll make sure to tweet you over the break.
Yep.
I'll promise it. All right. So on the behalf of the entire On the Crew staff, my name is Eric Conklin.
I'm Brittany Lee Carmichael.
And we hope you've had a great semester here with us. Thank you for joining us this season. We wish you happy holidays and a great rest of your finals week here at Rowan University.
Bye.
Bye.